Good morning. Welcome to Notre Dame Academy School's Mass. Today's Mass is hosted by 1st and 8th grade. It is the second week of Easter.
Our opening hymn is number 585 in the Red Worship. I want to walk as a child of the light. Number 585. Please stand.
Peace of Jesus our Lord be with you. To prepare ourselves, let us call to mind the ways we need the Lord's forgiveness and mercy. You were sent to heal the contrite heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. As we recall year by year the mysteries by which, to the restoration of its original dignity, human nature has received the hope of rising again, we earnestly beseech your mercy, Lord, that what we celebrate in faith we may possess in unending love. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The high priest rose up and all his companions, that is, the party of the Sadducees, and, filled with jealousy, laid hands upon the apostles and put them in the public jail. But during the night, the angel of the Lord opened the doors of the prison, let them out, and said, "Go and take your place in the temple area, and tell the people everything about this life." When they heard this, they went to the temple early in the morning and taught. When the high priest and his companions arrived, they convinced the Sanhedrin, the full senate of the children of Israel, and sent the jail to have them brought in. But the court officers who went did not find them in the prison, so they came back and reported, "We found the jail securely locked and the guards stationed outside the doors, but when we opened them, we found no one inside." When the captain of the temple guard and the chief priests heard this report, they were at a loss about them as to what this would come to. Then someone came in and reported to them, "The men whom you put in prison are in the temple area and are teaching the people." Then the captain and the court officers went and brought them, but without force, because they were afraid of being stoned by the people. The word of the Lord.
Our psalm is number 46 in the Blue Gather, The Cry of the Poor, number 46.
Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that everyone who believes in him might not perish, but might have eternal life. For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world might be saved through him. Whoever believes in him will not be condemned, but whoever does not believe has already been condemned, because he has not believed in the name of the only begotten Son of God. And this is the verdict, that the light came into the world, but people preferred darkness to light, because their works were evil. For everyone who does wicked things hates the light, but does not come toward the light, so that his works might not be exposed. But whoever lives the truth comes to the light, so that his works may be clearly seen as done in God. The Gospel of the Lord. Excuse me. Some of you may know me then because I come to church here off and on Sunday morning usually. My name is Father Theodore Campbell, and I'm a friend of Father Bauer's. And he asked me to come because he couldn't be here this morning. The spike is very much alive. When do you lock up the house? When do your parents lock up the house? Nighttime. Why do they lock up the house at nighttime? So no one can come in. And who is this no one? The robbers. Somebody, excuse me. That wasn't God. Okay, somebody's going to come in and rob you. People who want to do bad things will do it under cover of darkness, right? Because you can't see them as much. Now, one of the problems we have is if people start doing that during the day, it gets really dangerous, doesn't it? But would you not lock the doors at night? You keep on locking them at night, wouldn't you? Okay. Because there's still darkness. Now, the gospel this morning was talking about people who like to live in the light and people who like to live in the darkness. Why would people want to live in the darkness all the time? All the way back there. I'll have to go back in here. Okay, wait to meet. Oh, you're not truthful. And that's why you want to live in the darkness. Okay. You don't want to be caught telling a lie. Nothing to say. You want to be close to people. Because if you're close to people, they know what you're doing, right? Can you speak up a little bit? And then they don't have a good connection with God. I think we got the whole business. You might want to rob. You're lying and you're going to get caught. You're not close to God. You don't have a connection with God. Or you don't have it with other people. I wonder if the Holy Spirit's telling me not to talk. Thank you. Cold water, nice. Now that's what the gospel was talking about. People don't want to live in the light, or if the light comes to them, they resist it. But other people, if they see the light, they want to walk right into it. Because they're not afraid of being exposed or caught, or if they're a criminal, be arrested. And that's what the gospel is talking about. Good people go to the light when they see it. Bad people try to avoid it, resist it. And the difference between one or the other, what's the difference? They're doing the same thing. They're making up their minds about what they want to do, right? Now, what's the difference between people walking in the light people walking in the darkness? It's all in their heads, what they did. It's what they believed, right? Yeah. One thing's positive, the other thing's negative. That's a good way of looking at it. Particularly if you're making up the decision yourself. Do you want to be positive or negative? Do you want to be caught or have it back to mind? Gosh, I have to always worry about being caught, or you don't have to worry about that because you're open. And in the first reading, the apostles were talking about, they were trying to tell people that Jesus was the light, and if they came to Jesus, they would be free of their sins and of the evil and all this other stuff that pushes them down or makes them afraid, or they're always looking over their shoulders to see if they're going to get caught. If you're with Jesus, you don't have to worry about any of that stuff. But the problem was, the leadership in the Jewish community in Jerusalem didn't want that. They didn't want Christ. They didn't think he was the light of the world. So they were trying to tell the apostles to stop telling people about Jesus. And they put Peter in prison. But did that stop Peter? What happened to Peter when he was in prison? Anybody know, remember from the reading? He what? I'll have to get a little closer. Oh, who was that somebody? was an angel. And the angel broke open the doors of the prison and got Peter out. And he did that so that Peter could start talking again. Peter gets arrested again, goes on and on and on. Why do people fight the light? And that's the sad part. Why people want to be negative. Why they want to do bad things and in some ways disassociate from other people, lose their connection with God, always live in the fear of being caught. And on the other hand, people who live with in the light, who are positive, who connect with God and connect with other people, they live a life of freedom. And that's what Jesus has brought us. When he offers the light, we accept it and believe in him and walk with him, we're free. Okay? To the older kids, does that make sense? How about, where's the kindergarten? Is the kindergarten here? Okay. Oh, you're all spread around, huh? So I can't ask you for that communal help. Okay, well, we'll now start our prayer. But remember, if you live with Jesus, you're free. Even though people say that that's not the way it works, that is the way it works. Okay? Now for the prayers. Should we all stand? When we pray together in the name of Jesus our Lord, we always are confident that our Father will hear us.
We pray for Pope Francis, Bishop Hebda, and our Holy Catholic Church. We pray to the Lord. We pray for our community that we are prayerful and ready to do God's work. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the leaders of the world that they may work together to promote peace and justice. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who are sick, suffering, or in any kind of danger, especially those in Eastern Europe, that they would experience the healing power of Christ's love, we pray to the Lord.
Amen.
For our own needs and intentions that we hold in our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, and we also pray for Karen Mohegan, for whom we celebrate this Mass, we pray to the Lord. Grant us, Lord, what we offer you in the name of your Son, Jesus. As you heard him on the cross, hear us now. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Our preparation hymn is number 953 in the red hymnal. Alleluia, sing to Jesus. Jesus, number 953.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who by the wonderful exchange offered in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. He never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is the sacrificial victim who dies no more, the Lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. The fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all, for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope and Bernard our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be heirs to eternal life. We may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. We live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn is number 609 in the Blue Gather, Taste and See, number 609.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Mass is ended. Go in peace. Alleluia, alleluia.
Our closing hymn is number 516 in the red hymnal, Jesus Christ is Risen Today, number 516. Thank you.